O mundo está à beira de uma guerra. De um lado,
his music is so special to me and it means so much and it teaches me things. If you guys don't pick me, you won't accomplish your goal. You may pick someone else, but you won't accomplish your goal because you won't have the number one fan.
Ozzy has completely changed my life. He affects me every day. I listen to him every day. When people meet me, they're just like, oh, you're the girl that likes Ozzy.
I've been a Shaquille O'Neal fan since November 13th, 1993. When I saw that video, I was just like, whoa, he's flowing. You know, a ball player flowing like that. So I thought it was a fluke accident. But nevertheless, I went and bought that CD, Shaq Diesel. And it was so cold. It was so tight.
Ozzy Osbourne is a huge inspiration to me for a lot of reasons. First one is my friend took his own life back in February of 1997, and I became very, 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 very depressed when this happened because I just couldn't believe that someone my own age would take their own life. And I listened to Ozzy on the way to his funeral, and Ozzy's song See You on the Other Side helped me a lot. It sort of put a closure and a peace to what I was going through.
I'm more into Shaq's music than his basketball. I think his music is much more valuable. I didn't realize the effect that Shaq had on me or how similar our lifestyles were until I peeped his album, Shaq's Food to Return, when he did My Biological Didn't Bother.
Biological father left me in the cold when a few months old. I thought a child was greater than gold, but I guess not. You brought me into this world, but you're not my dad. Mess around with them drugs make my mom's mad.
That song, it hit me like a brick. When my mom passed back in 96, she was in the hospital only a week before she passed. Everybody thought she was gonna pull through. And I had finals that week. And my sister and grandmother, everybody told me, nah, you know, come after finals. I got to see my mom one day before she passed. And I felt so bad. I felt like college kept me from spending those last few days with my mother. And I was really angry with college. And I was ready to just pull out. I was ready to go home. I was feeling like, you know, maybe gang banging, drug dealing, pimping, or whatever was my calling. And it just dawned on me that Shaq had went through so many adversities in his life, and I think about that, and I look at myself and I say, hey, if I'm gonna be successful like Shaq, then I need to get my perspective together and get myself on the right path.
After my friend passed away, I became very, very depressed. And during this time, I dropped out of school maybe a week later after this happened. I just thought, I can't do this anymore, and I didn't want to go back to school. Everyone was talking about it, I didn't want to hear about it. I looked at Ozzy's life, and he came from dirt poor, and he went through the drugs, he went through the depression. Everyone hated him, and he's completely turned his image around. And now he's a great dad, he's a great husband, he's a great inspiration to many people like myself. And I just thought, you know, I really need to turn my life. So I started going back to school, and I'm interested in computers, and Ozzy helped me with that. I have an Ozzy webpage. It's become this, like, huge thing. Like, I work on it hours on end.
Totally unreal. Like, this is not reality. This doesn't happen to people like me.
We're going to see Ozzy. I'm ready. I'm so excited.
Oh, that's fine.
Woo! I'm already starting to cry. I knew I was going to. Ozzy's in there. Oh, my God, this is awesome.
Well, I hope I'm disappointed.
We're afraid to go inside.
Hello, sweetheart.
Ozzy.
Want to sit down?
Give me a hug.
Yeah. Sit down. Anyway, you like sit here, everyone. Oh, you came from Florida?
I came from West Palm Beach, Florida. They dragged me out of the ocean.
Wow.
I was in my bikini and everything.
Do you have some questions for you on our thing?
I have some questions. Who is your inspiration?
The Beatles.
Are they?
I know when I was younger than you, I mean, the Beatles happened in the 60s in England, and it was like
and magic was in the air. Every time the Beatles put out a new album, it was a definite new album. It wasn't the same as bounce off the last album. It was just a magical time in my life.
You're my inspiration. Do you want to know why?
Why?
There's a lot of reasons. You've inspired me to do so many things. Like, I think about you every day, and I listen to your music every day, and you keep me going. My friend took his own life back in February of 97. I couldn't believe it when I heard at work. It was such a shock, and I just thought, I can't do this. And I had to go to his funeral, and on the way to his funeral, I listened to See You on the Other Side, mm-hmm. and you wrote it about Sam Kinison, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it was, I heard you in that music sort of saying goodbye to Sam, so it applied to me saying goodbye to my friend.
It's nice when somebody says I help them through the day. I much prefer people to say I help them get through a crisis, to either a lyric or a melody or a song or a word that I said in a song.
It was the lyrics, though I know we must be parted, as sure as stars are in the sky, I'm going to see you when it comes to glory, when I see you on the other side.
Well, I honestly believe, with all this what we go through in this world, there has to be someone else. Why are so many of us here, and why are so many of us living different lives? We have to go, it has to be a journey for somewhere else. And it'd be a bit of a disappointment if after all these trials and errors you go through in life and then you die and you just end up in the floor. I hope there's like something better than this.
Mm-hmm. Your music is very inspirational. I dropped out of school after my friend committed suicide. I dropped out maybe 3 or 4 days later because I became like really depressed and I didn't want to do anything, and everyone at school was...
Did you go to counselling?
A little.
You should have gone for a grief thing.
I was very depressed, and I didn't go back to school for about 5-6 months. And I looked at your life, how, you know, you've done the drugs and you've done the partying, and, you know, the press was just all over you, and you just like had a bad reputation, and you completely turned your life around, you know. So I thought, you know, I need to like turn my life around, and be, you know, because I thought, you know, I'm so much better than this. I need to, you know, go back to school. So I went back to school, and I'm planning to go to college this fall. I want to go into computers, and you sort of helped me with that because I have a web page dedicated to you. I get like over 100 visitors a day, so that's what I want to do. I want to sort of go into that for my career.
If your heart's there, you'll get there, you know. You can't force anything. It's good that you've got an interest. It really is.
You're sort of a father for me.
Really?
Yeah.
where was I in what year? How guilty.
No, my parents got divorced about 4 or 5 years ago, and my dad moved away, and that's like when you sort of stepped in.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I could listen to you when I needed to, and I could watch your videos when I needed to. So you're Ozzy's my dad. That's what I tell people. You're like my dad.
Well, I hope I've been a good dad to you.
You have been a good dad. I finally get to meet my dad. When do you usually write your songs? Like, what kind of mood are you in?
Mostly when I'm very down. When I'm happy and everything's going well, I don't want to write. When I'm miserable, down, and the house is falling around, and I'm having a bad day with the wife, or something bad's happened, I'll sit and write a song, you know.
What do you hope your music brings to your fans?
Absolutely just fun. Just have a great time. I love it when I see them having a great fun.
I read in an interview you said you hope everyone has a little Aussie in them.
I that's what I believe. I mean, I like to put a little bit of me in. It's like seeing a million Aussies out there. I like them to come and join my band for the day, you know.
Aussie, I want you to meet my brother Matthew. He's the one that got me into you.
Hi, Matt.
Hello, Aussie.
Come on,
go through my sister.
So you were the one that got it all together for her?
Yes. This is the only thing I could pick out of her room because she's got millions of Aussie stuff, and I grabbed like the first thing.
Well, yeah, it's before you go. I'll have to give you my office phone number, and you'll have to, if you want any information, just phone the office.
Okay.
K-A-T-I-E.
So you met your number one fan.
Well, I hope I haven't disappointed you.
I've waited 6 years for this. This is so over the top.
Just a kiss.
I love you.
Great, thank you very much.
You're welcome, thank you.
Thank you very, very much.